about Goodwood Revival 2021. Well, it's a Sunday of the 3-day weekend. It's just about 8 o'clock in the morning. We're going to have a quick scoot round and just see what we can see. Ideally, you need 3 days to do this, but we're only here for the Sunday, so we'll have to make the most of it. Last time we were here was in 2015, and we brought Brig Dodge and put it in the middle of the paddock. Goodwood was its own stomping ground back in the day, from 1948 through to 1955. Oh yes, Mercedes. Vamo. I've got a Maserati 250F. And a Cooper. These are all part of the Stirling Moss celebration parade that's taking part later on. An XK120. A 328, I think. This is a Stirling Moss's old short wheelbase 250 Ferrari. There's Moss's Monaco winning Lotus. Let's have a peer into the inner paddock. Some real gems in the aviation section here. This is a Miles from 1936. This is a 1945 Mitchell.
No, but they're nice.
Got a Lysander. P38 Lightning.
Chris.
Got a Corsair. Got a P51D Mustang over here. Everywhere you look, there's just fascinating things, including this Austin 7 Chummy. There we go, a couple of Porsche 356s. Still a few things covered up. Unfortunately, not everything. Cobra. The Racing A35, this belongs to Nick Mason, I believe. This is giving me ideas for my A40, this is 1959 Mark 1. Alongside that, we've got a Mark 2. The saloon car racing at this year's Goodwood Revival is 1950s era. So we've got an Austin A90 from 1956, an A90 Westminster. This goes particularly well, not perhaps the most obvious of racing cars ever, but it seems pretty handy out on the track. We've got an A105 Westminster here. Another Austin A35. Phase 3 Vanguard, good heavens. I'm sure the engine never looked like that back in the day. MGYB getting a bit of TLC. An MG Magnet. And flying the flag for Volvo, we've got a PV544. Like I say, we couldn't hope to look at everything that's here in the space of one day, so we'll just have a look at some of the highlights for me. A Riley 1.5 racer here, due to be driven by Jochen Mass, ex-Formula 1 driver. Dink little Alpha Giulietta TI. In fact, a pair of Giuliettas.
I love them.
Over at the end, a Ford Prefect, 1958. This is prepared and driven by Andrew Jordan and Mike Jordan, this particular A40. We've got Austin Mini Cooper S. Another one alongside, and a low light Morris Minor. Many more Minis. There was a Mini only race, I think it was probably yesterday. This one appears to have met something solid. In fact, there are Minis everywhere you look. Many more over there, still covered up. And quite a few along here. Rauno Altonen. Andre Lotterer. Downton Tuned. Well, quite a famous Mark 1 here, by 1. A list of some of the drivers that have driven it, including Roy Salvadori, Peter Sargent, Gordon Williams, Grant Williams, Derek Bell, Jochen Mass. This has been competing here at Goodwood for years and years and is usually seen sideways around most of the circuit. In fact, this is Jaguar Row, another Mark 1, 1958. Another 58 car. Mighty Mark 7. One of the drivers is Rowan Atkinson. I think he raced yesterday. And over at the end, we've got a 1959 Ford Thunderbird. One of the theme displays this year is for BRM, British Racing Motors, and there's a huge collection of cars with links to BRM on display, and they will be going around the track a bit later. Well, it's 1974 BRM P201.
Golf cars parked here yesterday.
from the
next, John Surtees, P139 from 1969. If anyone's seen the restoration of the old Dodge truck from several years ago now, they'll know that the Rover BRM was stored in the same building and was worked on at the same time as the Dodge was being done. And here it is today, down at Goodwood. It's an incredible car, it just sounds like a jet aeroplane when it's running. A gas turbine car. Yet more BRMs, including a P25 here, but over here we have the Type 25 and another Type 25. And here is the recreated Mark 1 BRM V16. They're planning to build four of these in all, as close to exact replicas of the originals as possible. And the theory being that, whereas the originals are a little bit temperamental, hopefully they can build a little bit of reliability into these so they can be run on a more regular basis, hopefully. I doubt we'll ever see this many V16s in one place ever again. This is the Mark II V16 BRM with the smaller air intake. While here we've got an original 1950 BRM V16. Absolutely incredible car. 16 cylinders, 1.5 litre. And if that wasn't enough, we got another one over here, also 1950. If you haven't seen it already, there is a separate video elsewhere on the channel which shows one of these up and running, and it really is quite something to behold. The noise is just something else. Many, many ERAs along here. This is the famous R5B Remus, as owned and raced by Prince Bearer back in the day. Absolutely phenomenal collection of cars. You just never see this many historic racing cars in one place. There are quite a few historic races around, but nothing really compares with this. Like I said before, to see all those BRM V16s in one place was just incredible. Something like this. Couple of Fraser Nashes down here. No shortage of Jaguar D-types either. 774RW. That is the reconstructed original 1955 Le Mans winner. Over there is the famous Ecuria Cost Transporter. Big old comma. Just a few more Jaguars. Yeah. just have a look at some of the other displays around here as we make our way up to the circuit itself.
the name Jerry Dan comes from. That's good, come along though. Well done, thank you. I heard you support the structure here. Thank you. gently had a very strong cast of the
Well, that's our day at Goodwood come to an end. I hope that short video was of interest. We'll try and get back here again next year. Obviously we couldn't cover everything that's here and going on today. We need all 3 days for that, but just as a taste, I hope this video was of interest if you haven't actually been to the Revival before. Please check out some of the other videos on the channel and more videos along very, very soon. Thanks for now.
Oh yeah, that's the other Elvis Skelter.